Welcome to the New Hampshire Housing Multifamily Development Virtual Tour. We'll be highlighting how our financing has helped our for-profit and nonprofit partners build different types of apartment properties around the state. This financing comes primarily from the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program, Home Investment Partnerships Program, and Housing Trust Fund. These sources, along with the tax-exempt bond financing and the state's Affordable Housing Fund, support construction and related costs to create and preserve affordable housing units in communities around the Granite State. Many of these multifamily projects will also receive financing from the Governor's InvestNH initiative, which is intended to accelerate the construction of affordable workforce housing. InvestNH is financed through the state's allocation of fiscal recovery funds. 32 new projects were underway in fiscal year 2022. When they're completed, there will be an additional 1,792 multifamily housing units, 1,436 general occupancy apartments, 258 units for seniors, and 98 units or beds for people who need supportive services as well as housing. The first completed property on our tour is Apple Ridge Apartments Phase 2 in Rochester. It's located near public transportation and employers in the Lilac City and surrounding communities. This three-phase project was developed by DR Lemieux Builders and will provide a total of 102 units of workforce housing when the third phase is completed. Phase 2 has 34 units and a community room and laundry facilities. The property meets passive house building standards, meaning that it is well insulated and uses natural light and solar gain, along with highly efficient HVAC systems to keep utility and other costs low. This project was funded in part through the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program and Home Investment Partnerships Program. The next property is Bridge Street Recovery in Bennington, located next to Crotchet Mountain Ski Resort. The developer 1810 Realty Group acquired a vacant motel and rehabilitated the building to create a 32-unit housing facility for adults with substance use disorder. Bridge Street Recovery provides high-quality treatment supporting long-term recovery, along with sober living transitional housing apartments for low and very low-income adults. It was funded in part with state affordable housing funds. Bagdad Wood in Durham, a property open to seniors and people with disabilities, is close to restaurants, medical services, and downtown's amenities. Its developer, Housing Initiatives of New England, completed this renovation of an existing 40-unit property for seniors and constructed 26 additional units. Bagdad Wood also offers residents access to services. This property was funded in part by federal low-income housing tax credits and tax-exempt bonds. Located in the scenic Upper Valley region, Summer Park Residences Phase 1 in Hanover serves seniors ages 62 and older, as well as people with disabilities. The 24-unit building replaced three buildings constructed in the 1970s. This new building offers open floor plans, wider doorways, and other features that make it more accessible to residents with disabilities. The property meets passive house building standards and was developed by Twin Pines Housing and funded in part by the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program. With median rents for one- and two-bedroom apartments in downtown Portsmouth being among the highest in the state, the new workforce housing development Ruth, Lewin, Griffin Place is especially welcome in the city. Griffin Place offers affordable rents and is in walking distance to businesses, schools, public transportation, and services. Portsmouth Housing Authority developed and owns the property. It has 64 units, a common room, laundry room, and parking. Griffin Place was funded in part by the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program and the state's Affordable Housing Fund. Speaking at the ribbon cutting for Griffin Place, Portsmouth Housing's Executive Director Craig Welch noted, "The shortage of affordable housing in the state is a complex and frustrating challenge to solve. With leadership at New Hampshire Housing, developers, policymakers, local land use boards, investors, and neighbors collaborated to respond to Portsmouth's need for permanently affordable housing." The next four projects receive funding approval in fiscal year 22 and are under construction. River Turn Woods in Conway is being developed by Avesta Housing and is funded through the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program. When its first phase is completed, there will be 40 new units in the Mount Washington Valley, a popular residential and tourist area. Harvey Heights Phase 2 in Meredith is being developed by Lakes Region Community Developers. This 25-unit general occupancy preservation rehab project is funded through the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program. 323 Manchester Street in downtown Manchester is being developed by the Mental Health Center of Greater Manchester. The center provides support to individuals to achieve recovery and promote personal and community wellness. This project is a renovation of 16 single-room occupancy units and adds 6 more units. Mental health services are provided to all residents. This project is funded in part by the State Affordable Housing Fund through New Hampshire Housing Supportive Housing Program. And the last project on this tour is Monahan Manor, formerly known as Bronstein Apartments, in downtown Nashua. It is being developed by the Nashua Housing and Redevelopment Authority in Boston Capital. There will be 216 apartments when completed, with financing from the Federal Low-Income Housing Tax Credit Program and tax-exempt bonds. Thank you for joining our virtual tour of multifamily projects and properties financed by New Hampshire Housing. All of these new units will become homes for our state's workforce, families, retirees, and others who want and need a safe, affordable place to call home. Like Diamond, the membership coordinator at New Hampshire PBS, and her daughter. Previously, they lived for several years in a tiny one-bedroom apartment. At Griffin Place, they have their own bedrooms and can walk to Devon's school, the library, and a playground. And their rent and utility costs are 20% less than previously. Or Alyssa, who works at Seacoast Rep and is thrilled to live in the city where she works and in a place she can truly afford. And Judy, a retired nurse and pastor, who now has space to quilt and sew and is grateful to have a home in the community she loves. And Pat and Jim, with their dog Mac, who love walking around downtown Durham and playing pickleball. Learn more about New Hampshire Housing's Multifamily Housing Division and its program financing at nhhousing.org.